benign and popular. Today, we celebrate the Mass for the fourth Sunday of Easter. Our processional friend of God, please rise.
Yeah. us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach with the brave shepherd as God before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
I know my sheep, and mine with me. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down, and power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today the church celebrates what's traditionally referred to as Good Shepherd Sunday. And it's that time of the year, that Sunday of the year, where we reflect on the fact that our God is like a shepherd who keeps careful watch over his flock so that no one be lost. He is even that shepherd that will leave the 99 in search of the one who's wandered off. I don't know if we have any former shepherds here. I've never been a shepherd like that. But I once read an article about what shepherds do and why they're so important to the flock. And the main reason is that sheep are pretty vulnerable. They have no way of defending themselves from the wolves. They're very gentle. What's more, sheep are not particularly smart animals. They can wander off fairly easily, and they have a hard time finding their way back. And so for that reason, they need the protection of a good shepherd who's going to watch over them and to keep them from getting lost in the wilderness or getting attacked by wolves or other wild animals. I think sometimes we get frustrated when we get compared to sheep. You know, nobody likes to be compared to dumb, defenseless animals. But the older I get, and the more mistakes I make in my life, the more I realize that maybe we are more like sheep than we like to think. You know, because we do get lost from time to time. We wander off. Human beings are certainly smarter than sheep, and yet sometimes we do some very stupid things. And what's more, we sometimes ignore all of the warning signs, wander into a dangerous situation, and then discover that the wolf is waiting for us. Hello. We have a future priest. That's okay, don't worry about it at all. And we should also never forget that there are a lot of wolves out there in the world. This world can be a very violent place sometimes. That's why we need a good shepherd. We need someone who's going to call us back from the edge, who's going to keep us safe, who would even lay down his life for us. And in Jesus, we have the good shepherd who's always watching over us. We may still make mistakes. We may still get lost. We may do something stupid. But if we focus on Jesus, then we're not going to get too far off track before we find our way back to safety. And if we wait too long, the good shepherd will come and search on us. I once read also that shepherds usually like to keep each other company, since those hours out in the pasture can get very long, especially when you're alone. So they like to hang out together. And I think this probably gets mentioned in homilies a lot around the world, that, you know, that when these shepherds get together, together. They all bring these large flocks, and they get mixed up with each other. But at the end of the day, when it's time for them to go home, each shepherd calls out to his sheep, and the different groups of sheep separate themselves out and follow their own shepherd. They know which voice to follow. And for us as Christians, there's only one voice that we should be following, and that's the voice of Jesus. Because in this world, there are a lot of other voices out there that we could be following. And let's face it, some of them can be very attractive, but they lead us the wrong way. They get us into dishonesty, or selfish behavior, or violence, or addiction. All we have to do is turn on the TV, and we can hear a lot of voices telling us to live in a way that's anything but Christian. And that's why we need that good shepherd who leads us as we pray, as we read the Bible, as we come together for liturgy, so that we never lose track of what our own shepherd's voice sounds like. Because if we keep listening to the voice of Jesus, we'll never get lost. But most of the time, we need each other to be able to know how to listen to Jesus' voice. And that's why we stick together. That's why we come together as a community, because it's together that we can hear the voice of the Good Shepherd most clearly. Also, this weekend is World Day to pray for vocations. And so we also pray for more vocations to priesthood and diaconate, to the consecrated life, and to lay ministry, so that we'll have shepherds willing to lay down their lives for us and to keep our faith community close to God and to each other. And I've known a lot of priests and religious over the years who've gone through some extremely difficult times in their lives. Some of them have suffered terribly, but I don't know a single one who would not do it all over again. And once Christ seizes our heart, there's no turning back. We also have a number of people in our parish who've gone through the Archdiocesan Lay Formation Program. Dee White's in it right now. How many of you here have done that? I know we've got several here. We've got Jewel, Deb, we've got Gus, Pam. Anyone else? We've got several people that have done that. I've never been in a parish that's had so many people go through that program. And you know, we can see what the fruits of that is and how much our parish is blessed with that. So as we continue with this liturgy, we give thanks for all of those people who have formed us in the faith. And we pray that we're able to work together to help form this next generation of shepherds. There's also one other thing that doesn't really fit as much with the homily, but you might have noticed, you might have seen that this past week, the Missouri House of Representatives passed a piece of legislation saying that if it is approved, we can no longer say guns are not welcome in our worship spaces. People will have the right to bring their guns into church, whether we like it or not. And of course, as followers of the Prince of Peace, we stand against that. So I think it's very important that we write to our legislators and to our governor and let them know that we are against this piece of legislation. You know, how many homicides occur in churches? Nationwide, some years, most years, none. And when there is occasionally a tragedy, it's a few people out of millions of people that go to Mass each week or to church each week. We don't need this legislation. And some of these legislators are so good at arguing in favor of religious liberty when it comes to healthcare initiatives. And so we hope that they're going to extend that same eloquence to arguing against, arguing in favor of religious liberty so that we have the right to say no to something that will only result in violence. As soon as this becomes an issue and guns are being brought into church and some of these advocates are making a point to bring guns into church, that's when we're going to see the violence. Doesn't protect us. And so we pray that this doesn't happen. We pray as a community we can inform these people that we do not want this. So we take a moment to renew our commitment to living on our baptism each day. And so please stand. And I ask you, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
Amen.
For the church and those who lead us, and especially Pope Francis, that he may have the courage to continue to help the church live the gospel of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governments, that they may care for the needs of the people rather than sowing division, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to gun violence and our nation's fascination with weapons, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ongoing reform of our government, military, police departments, and all institutions that are meant to protect us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to ordained ministry, consecrated life, and lay ministry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those who despair, that they may experience the healing care of the Good Shepherd, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We take a moment to place in God's hands the concerns we carry in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, we thank you for the tender care you extend to us through the Good Shepherd. Help us to extend that care to one another. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
creation, with your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Therefore, Lord, as we
are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, we become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation be grateful, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Mitchell our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family that you have summoned before you, and your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say,
First of all, just the ACA making progress. We are up to $1,643 after 1 week, and the goal is $8,288, so that's really great progress. Yeah, it's pretty fast. So, of course, this is what's financing so many of our archdiocese and ministries, especially to the poor. So cards are in the back, they're duplicates of what you hopefully received in the mail. You can turn them in the collection, you can mail them in, or you can go to our website and just follow the link if you prefer to pay online. So thank you very much for that. Also today at 4 p.m. or any time after, the Longa Center's Testimony Awards, what is normally a dinner, this year is a ceremony that's going to be posted online. But our parishioner Tom Lyons is being honored for all of the call him all the time. I had to get the lawnmower out of the garage and it was locked. He talked me through it on the phone this week. He's amazing. But we're very grateful for everything that he does. So if you go to our website and follow the link, that will take you to that ceremony. And it'll be on for a while. It'll just be for one time. Also, do we have anyone visiting today? Any visitors? Who do we have here that's returning for the first time since the COVID shutdown? We also have the blessing of some prayer shawls.
As is our custom here at Saints Teresa and Bridget, we have a shawl ministry in which we make a prayer shawl for any member of our community who has lost a member of their family or has gone through some serious illness. So we've been on hiatus for a year because of COVID. So these shawls that we're giving out today should have been given out a year ago. But I just ask you to extend your hand in blessing of the shawls. We have a shawl for Carolyn Ford, our sister who had surgery. We have a shawl for Sharon Reed Usry, who lost her dad, her uncle, and her whole family was quite ill. And we have a shawl for Pam White, whose mom, we all know, Mrs. Marvelous, went home to the Lord last year. So let's, as I pray this over, may God's grace be upon these shawls, warming, comforting, enfolding, and embracing. May this mantle be a safe haven, a sacred place of security and well-being, sustaining and embracing in good times as well as difficult ones.